Aradhya being 1.5 year old, we were quite worried on how the outcome comes out. If hadn't been for the test, we wouldn't have even come to know that they were positive. We were the first case in Vani. So even the Vani officials didn't know on what exactly needed to be done. Only two bathrooms were available for 40 of us. It was difficult for me to clean Aradhya also. It was quite draining. You can hear people coughing the whole day and night, and that demotivates you all the more. The mental stress was something which was killing you. Over there, no one helps you. You're all alone because everyone's scared of you since you are a COVID positive person. So we moved from Mumbai to Vane because the cases over at Mumbai were getting worse. We wanted to kind of safeguard Aradhya from it. We were not aware what the future held for us. So it started with my dad. He had started developing fever. Earlier we thought it might be the weather change or the long 16 to 19 hours drive that he has done. But when the fever didn't subside, we thought we should get this test done at Nagpur. He was going, my mother was also going because she was the one who was taking care of him. My chacha was the one who drove him from Vani to Nagpur. All the three turned out to be positive. Aradhya didn't show any kind of symptoms. Hence, we were surprised when she tested positive. Even though my dadi didn't show any symptoms. We were surprised at first on how is it possible that my daughter, who is with me 24/7, is with me and still I am negative. Since my parents were admitted in Nagpur, we thought that it would be better if we could also get an admission in the Nagpur hospital itself because I'll have some support. This happened in the night around 9:30 that we were shifted to the quarantine center. So quickly we were asked to wrap things around and move from Vani to Yavatmal that we hardly had any time to gather stuff. I just picked up my daughter's suitcase and took it with me. My dadi was hardly able to get all her medicines also in the bag. In the morning around 10 o'clock we were told that Aradhya and dadi were tested positive. The first quarantine center was a makeshift from a college to a quarantine center. So the classrooms were converted into bedrooms, I'll say. The windows were broken so the insects could come in anytime, go out anytime they want. We were the first case in Vani. So even the Vani officials didn't know on what exactly needed to be done. Our rooms weren't clean for like 2 to 3 days. Then when we had to put like real pressure on these officials, it was cleaned at last. There was so much dirt. The bathrooms were common bathrooms. In let's say college, you have one bathroom for the whole floor. Only two bathrooms were available for 40 of us. The whole floor was covered with water. So it was difficult for me to clean Aradhya also. On the 7th day, we were then discharged. And earlier we were told that we'll be home quarantined. But suddenly we were taken to another quarantine center at Yavatmal. So there were just two beds. So I had to share it with my daughter, which was a bit difficult. But then she adjusted. More than me, she adjusted to me. With respect to my day in the hospital, it used to go like this. I used to get up in the morning around 7-ish because Aradhya used to get up at around 8-ish. So 7 to 8 being my time, I had to get done with my brushing, to cleaning of the place, to wrapping up stuff that's been lying around in the night. She used to play, she used to have her breakfast, and then she used to doze off at around 11 a.m. Once she dozed off, I had to wash all the utensils, whatever there was, then wash all my clothes, her clothes, my grandma's, if there are something. I used to sweep the room and then pocha bhi marna padta tha kyunki raat ko keede bahut aaye the. And once that was done, there used to be sanitization that had to be done by the hospital. Around 1 o'clock, she used to wake up, then we used to have a lunch, then she used to play around a bit, digest her food, and then around 4 o'clock, we used to go for a bath. Once having a bath, she used to play a bit and again fall asleep around 5 p.m. Again, at that time, the remaining of the clothes needs to be washed, the cleaning needs to be done. I used to get some me time over there where I used to Netflix or just watch Friends for a peace of mind, nothing else. When she was up, again, the playing used to start, the feeding used to start, whatever my dadi demands or asks. that needs to be given. I used to give hot water bags to my dadi because she had quite severe stomach issue, so that needed to be taken care of. And by around 8:30ish times, we used to have our dinner. Then again, used to play to tire her out. That was my motive for the whole day, to tire her out as much as possible. Around 10:30ish times, we used to go to sleep. And once she was asleep, I had to safeguard her from all kind of insects. It was a lot of Odomos that used to go on her hands, on her face, on her feet. Then I used to get up every 2 to 3 hours in the night just to reapply that Odomos, because the insects and the mosquitoes were like really crazy out there. They used to bite. I got a real bad allergy on my neck, on my face. However, the protection I had used, she had bite marks all over her legs and hands also. This went on for around 6 days that we were there. Then later on, we were shifted to a quarantine center in Yavatmal. It was around like 5-7 minutes away from the hospital that we were in. Over there, we were told that we'll be staying there for 7 days again. This was the third place now we were shifted to, which was the government hospital. So this hospital was a very, very old building. Luckily, we were given one room, private room, between me, Dadi and Aradhya. Along with our room, there were two more rooms where serious COVID patients were admitted. The whole 6-7 days in the hospital was quite draining. Moreover, what happens is I was negative, I had to take care of myself. Apart from that, there are patients around you. You can hear people coughing the whole day and night. You can see people not being well. That demotivates you all the more. Though you are okay, you don't have any kind of illness, touch wood, but still just being around these people demotivates you or makes you feel ill for yourself. At the end of this hospital time, even my dadi started, who was asymptomatic, started feeling that no, I'm not okay, no, something is wrong with me, no, something is happening to me. Though there was no symptoms at all, no fever, nothing at all, but just the surrounded started affecting us a lot. Even Aradhya, she's not a crybaby at all, but during the last 1-2 days, even she was low on energy. She sometimes just started crying, out of the blue started crying. I should not understand what is happening. The biggest problem over here was you are going through such a big disease or such a big virus. You are infected, you are not well, but you are all alone in this fight. Eventually, I stopped thinking on how stressed I am or how tired I am, because you just can't go on just thinking, my goodness, I'm so homesick, I am so tired. You just don't have that opportunity. You have to go on. You have no other option. For your daughter, for your grandma, you have to go on. And I went on. I stopped thinking. To keep Aradhya entertained, I had to come up with new stuff. We used to just crank up some music in the evening around 7 o'clock time. Have some garbaras, dandiya, or whatever we used to play. We used to sing along. We used to dance along. There were various kind of rhymes that I used to narrate to her, stories I used to narrate to her. She used to action it out. Then there was like Hathi Bhai To Chado kind of Gujarati song. Then I got a packet full of murmura. She had a small kitchen set and she used to cook over there the murmura. She used to make roti, she used to make sabji, she used to make chai, she used to give it to me. She used to have fun. My end of relatives, they got Aradhya a few new clothes. She used to be excited about that as well. So whatever new used to happen, I tried to take it for the whole day. I used to keep her busy around that new thing for the whole day, so that at least one day gets passed. When I got 3-4 different toys for her, I made sure that one day is given to each toy. One day I used to just give her one new toy. The whole day used to go behind that. Then the second toy used to come on the next day. So then the whole day used to go. So like that, you have to future plan as well as plan for a current thing as well. And hence the day is passed on. Aradhya made some good friends over there. The hospital staff were quite happy to see her. All the doctors used to come one by one. They used to wear new PPE kits so as to not get a disease from her or give her anything also in return. So they used to play with her for like 1 minute, 2 minute max. They used to make sure that they come every day or morning, evening they used to come. They used to just say hi to her. Or from a distance, they used to say hi Aradhya, bye Aradhya. कैसी है यार अध्या, that used to happen. Then even at the quarantine center where there were a few other kids as well, they couldn't play along with her, but they could just talk from a distance. And she used to get all excited seeing so many kids around her. They used to show their toys to her, she used to show their toys to her. Eventually the days passed and the seventh day, around 3 or 4-ish times, we were told that we are getting discharged. Until we were told that we are getting discharged, I didn't pack anything because I just didn't want hopes go up and come crashing down again. I was told, Sanskriti, you are getting discharged, was the next second, everything was packed. I literally rushed and started dumping everything in this bag, that bag, made sure everything was packed or just leave it where it is. I am going home. The best part of this was our send off. Yes, it was a send off because all the staff people, quite many patients, everyone had come down just to say bye to Aradhya. Everyone was waving bye Aradhya, be in touch with us Aradhya. And yes, we are in touch with those quarantined patients as well. Once in the ambulance, that journey was the most beautiful journey I've ever taken. I suddenly started appreciating the nature around me. We had the best sleep possible that night, stress free, at home after a long time. What this 18 days have taught me, 3 important stuff: hope, family and love. Hope was a thing which kept me going that everything will be well. Family, their support meant everything to me in these 18 days. Without them, without their kind words, without their support, it wouldn't have been possible. Love between families, between friends, between strangers, between kids and doctors, between the cleaning staff and the patients. At the end, it's just love, family, hope that you have, nothing else. The way doctors are working so hard, I being a negative was feeling something like this. They are surviving or they are living within these positive patients. On how tough or how heartbreaking it might be for them to survive in such kind of conditions. All I can say at the end is God bless us all, nothing else. Thank you.
Even though we did not want to be apart from each other, we had to.
I also feel that people in India are very unaware of how serious this is.
ये देखिए, ये है मेरा room. ये kitchen है.
हमने कोई safe feel नहीं कर रहे हैं आप लोगों के साथ, कुछ भी नहीं.